Everyone, welcome to morning prayer. It's good to see people continuing to arrive. We have some music today. We have our morning prayer service. We will do gospel-based discipleship, which is reading the scripture together twice and reflecting on it together. We've decided this week we're going to stay in a large group for that, and then we just are trying to mix it up, going back and forth between going into small groups versus staying in the large. So this week we'll stay all together for that reflection. What else to say? It is Mother's Day. Mm-hmm. We will offer a prayer for Mother's Day. Really aware that Mother's Day brings lots of emotion. It brings a whole lot and plenty of gratitude. And also there are some other feelings that people have around that. So I selected a prayer that hopefully will speak to the complexity of Mother's Day. But I do want to say a special greeting to people for whom you celebrate that day. What else to say? We will do the reading twice. So I will ask for a volunteer for the second reading. Guy will read it the first time. Is that good for now, Nan? Yeah,
sounds good.
Well, again, welcome. And I'm glad you all are here. And we will enter into our time of prayer.
Oh, hold on here. I think, David, you have to, I'm going to take the host back because it's, okay. Something was disabled. It's still showing that.
I just made you the host.
Yeah.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Creator and to the Christ and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia. The Lord is risen indeed. Come, let us adore him. Alleluia.
Come. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
A reading from Psalm 98. Sing a new song to God, who has done marvelous things. With your right hand, O God, and your holy arm, you have won for yourself the victory. You have made known your victory. Your righteousness have you openly shown in the sight of nations. You remember your mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel, and all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout out with joy to the God of all your lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to God with the harp and the voice of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before our God, who reigns in majesty. Let the sea make a noise and all that is in it, and lands that those who dwell therein. Let the river clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before God, who will come to judge the earth. God shall judge the world in righteousness and the people with equality.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people? Who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Surely it is God who saves me. Trusting him, I shall not fear. For the Lord defends and shields me, and his saving help is near. So rejoice as you draw water from salvation's living spring. In the day of your deliverance, thank the Lord, his mercy sing. Make his deeds known to the peoples, tell out his exalted name. Praise the Lord who has done great things, all his works his might proclaim. Zion, lift your voice in singing, for with you has come to dwell. In your very midst, the great and holy one of Israel.
So as I said earlier, we will reflect on scripture again together. And for me, it's one of the great gifts of this time of Zoom worship is hearing from one another. As has become our custom in Zoom morning prayer, we'll hear the gospel read twice. The first time we'll hear one translation, and then the second time a different translation. And we'll ask questions for reflection. For the first time reading this scripture, I'll ask you to pay attention to the words you hear closely. And what is a word or phrase that stands out to you in your hearing of this gospel today? A word or phrase, and we'll offer those aloud and in the chat after we hear Guy read the gospel.
A reading from the Gospel of John. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite your responses, a word or phrase that stands out in the hearing of this gospel today.
I think love one another stands out to me.
I chose you.
Called you friend.
Fruit that will last.
In light of my reading this morning, we've been voluntold. Love as I have loved. You did not get to choose, I chose you. I appointed you, you've been voluntold. So that just really hit me. All of those things from what I read this morning.
Thank you. Is there a volunteer who would read the gospel a second time? Is there someone, voluntold? I might, Virginia, I see you first. So if you would, from the translation, the message. And again, the question this time is, how are you particularly called this day, challenged, inspired, called, voluntold, as you hear the reading this second time?
I've loved you the way my Father loved me. Make yourselves at home in my love. If you keep my commands, you'll remain intimately at home in my love. That's what I've done, kept my Father's commands and made myself at home in his love. I've told you these things for a purpose, that my joy might be your joy and your joy wholly mature. This is my command. Love one another the way I loved you. This is the very best way to love. Put your life on the line for your friends. You are my friends when you do the things I command you. I'm no longer calling you servants, because servants don't understand what their master is thinking and planning. No, I've named you friends because I've let you in on everything I've learned from the Father. You didn't choose me, remember, I chose you and put you in the world to bear fruit, fruit that won't spoil. As fruit bearers, whatever you ask the Father in relation to me, he gives you. But remember the root command, love one another. The word of the God. the word of the Lord. Excuse me. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
How does this inspire, challenge, call you this day in the hearing of this gospel?
I like the, not like, but I mean, I think what I hear about it that's different than what I've heard, this is one of my favorite passages, is, you know, I'm familiar with, you know, love one another as I have loved you. And I always thought that meant, you know, I've loved you, so you need to love each other. But when this message says, love others the way I have loved you, so it's not only that you need to do it, but it's also a statement about how you need to do it. And I think that's something I haven't really quite thought about in exactly that way before. And to me, that's a real powerful and even a much sort of higher calling. And so I think that's really, really neat.
And David, that what you said, that's really scary, because Jesus gave up his life for us in one of the most horrible ways imaginable. And I remember this story as a child, and I don't know how, you know, how true it is, but it's something my mother told me. I was raised Roman Catholic, and my mom said that at the time when I was a young child, Pope Pius XII was the Pope. And my mom used to tell a story that she heard that, you know, Pope Pius as a child said, Jesus, I will follow you and love others as you have loved me, but without the nails. And that just always has stuck with me, that it's really, we're really called to doing something really difficult. Good.
This is Marilyn. I was struck by, in this reading, the abiding in the love as the Father loved Jesus. It's kind of like that phrase, hurt people. And in the same manner, loved people love others. So as we abide and are loved and receive the love, it's not an effort for us to pass that on.
I was thinking along those same lines, and the word that I was thinking of from the first reading was complete, how abiding, that reciprocity of we abide in God and Jesus and Jesus abides in us, and that equilibrium and so on, it just makes a complete union for us to move forward. And I thought it was interesting that complete didn't show up in the message. I can't remember exactly how they said it, but they didn't seem to bring that concept through.
I'm struck by, there's a phrase in there that could get taken wrong, which is I don't have it right here in front of me, but that basically, if you do, you know, if you follow, I say, then you're my friends. Or it seems to come across that way. It's like, well, you gotta do this stuff first, then you'll be my friend. But I think the sense of this thing is kind of, it's the other way around. It's because you're my, the fact you do the things like I do is kind of a sign that you're my friend, that you live these things out. You know, because sometimes we get into, well, you know, if I don't do all this, then he's not my friend. I think the feeling of this, especially as you get the part about bearing fruit, you know, just being there in the world, it strikes me that we are out there, and often I just like to say, we do the right thing and weren't even aware of it. It's like, oh, okay. So I take it that way.
I was struck by Dietrich Bonhoeffer, who was in New York and during World War II and wanted to go back home, and his friends wanted him to stay, and he went back to Germany because he had to help and do something. And he gave his life for his friends who he didn't know. Mm-hmm. And what a powerful manifestation of love he was.
Mm-hmm. So when I was growing up, we had like about 60 teenagers. We always had our special service and everything like that. We had this youth group that was actually enormous, and I play the piano. So I play the piano on every Sunday. Somebody had asked for "What a Friend We Have in Jesus," that song. You know, I practically had it memorized by the time I graduated from high school, because it was just, it came up so many times. It's kind of an old chestnut, but this Bible passage, all of a sudden, I don't think I thought about it up until today, that it's probably linked to that idea that Len was talking about, about being a friend.
Well, I was just, you know, I'm thinking about Mother's Day, and I was thinking about this notion that I would do anything for my children. I would lay down my life for my children. If I had to choose my life or their life, I would choose their life over my own. And this, that kind of fierce love, I think about Bonhoeffer and Mary's comment about Dietrich Bonhoeffer, that he was able to, you know, be moved to lay down his life for people he did not know. And to, that's a really bold challenge. It's really hard to imagine stepping into such sacrifice, such sacrificial love. But I can kind of get a taste of it as a mother, that I imagine that I could do that for my children. And what does that mean, that I'm called into a kind of that kind of radical love for others too? That's really challenging.
Catherine, I like the fact that God gives us free will to make a choice to love him. I mean, he or she or whatever, the divine, could have made it so that we just blindly follow God and like automatons, but that wouldn't be really a true test of our hearts. And I think God decided, well, I need to see who's going to choose me. And so I think Jesus is saying the same thing. He's, you know, the friends and Jesus sort of chose each other, even though he says in that passage, you didn't choose, or something about choosing. But I think the point is just that it's a reciprocal deal. You know, when the hearts are connected, it's that we do it out of choice. We want to love God, and we want to love others.
Thank you all for reflecting on this. You helped bring the scripture alive today. Thank you. Let us reaffirm our faith by saying the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, And forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Sanctifying God, your gift to us is one who overcame the system which enslaves and feeds upon the victim. Send us to your world to speak the truth of peace, to stand with those who suffer, to show another way through Jesus Christ, the life of all things.
Amen.
Let us pray for all the mothers among us today, for our own mothers, those living and those who have died, for the mothers who loved us and for those who fell short of loving us fully, for all who hope to be mothers someday and for those whose hope to have children has been frustrated, for all mothers who have lost children, for all women and men who have mothered others in any way, those who have been our substitute mothers, and we who have done so for those in need, for the earth that bore us and provides our sustenance. We pray this all in the name of God, our great and loving mother. Amen.
Amen.
O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you that the week to come may be spent in your favor through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hard wood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you for the honor of your name. Amen. I invite your prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings, and you could put them in the chat or offer them aloud, or offer them in the silence of your own heart.
For all countries dealing with COVID outbreaks.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. You've promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Amen.
Alleluia, alleluia, let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.
Glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen.
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 Thank you all. And I want to say a special thanks to Kathy for singing this morning. I want to say, when I was in seminary, we went to morning prayer 5 days a week, Monday through Friday. We were required to go to morning prayer for 3 years, every 5 days a week, I did morning prayer. And that music is so deeply embedded in me. And Kathy, thanks for bringing it alive here so beautifully and letting us sing along with, for some of us, that's really important music that we haven't heard in a while. So thank you. And thank you to our readers and participants. As always, be in touch if you want to participate in a leadership role. We will be having Zoom worship again next Sunday. And then after that, so 2 weeks from today, we will be at church outdoors for Pentecost. So that'll be great. We have the bell choir doing their ringing. And we also will have Charity Harvilla will be singing. It's the day where we celebrate the gifts of the descent of the Spirit. And hi to David's cat on the chat. And so we invite you, if you are coming to worship live, or even if you're going to tune in later, wear colors of the flame, red, orange, yellow, and we'll kind of make a big day of it. So what else needs to be announced today? Anyone else? I will say, I thought Robbie Stokes did an excellent job of presenting on the endowment last Wednesday night. And it was just really informative and really provocative questions about legacy and some other things. So I believe that was maybe recorded. Oh, maybe not. I can't remember, but thank you to all who were part of that. Anything else?
Mona, did the youth group come and help in the garden? Was that this week?
No, it got rained out.
Oh.
So we rescheduled for Wednesday. So that gave me time to come up with some more things for them to do.
Good.
So they've been voluntold, huh?
So I guess we'll just kind of morph into coffee hour. Feel free to grab a cup of something and...